Well, I wanted to ask you about what life is like in Rojava, but before that, you said like you're in the rear now after spending 3 months at the front. So what can you tell us about, like you said, it's a process that like they lost a great deal of territory as sort of ISIS moved in, and then it was a process of taking it back bit by bit. So what can you tell us about what that campaign has been like this summer or up until now?
Well, so when I got here, I thought we were going to go for the city called Al-Bab, which is sort of like the last, it's kind of ISIS's corridor to Turkey. There's three cantons in Rojava that's called Jizir, which I'm in right now, which is tight because it has Jiz in the name.
It's
Kobani Canton, and this thing called Afrin Canton. Yeah, just tight.
In Afrin Canton, they call him Brother Brace.
Yeah, I don't know what the fuck a canton is. It's like a county. So that was the last Al-Bab. If we took Al-Bab, it would be like the last city we would need to connect all three cantons. And Afrin, apparently, which is kind of the one like the furthest west and disconnected from everybody, they have like fucking Abrams tanks and like, you know, Katushas and shit. We have like one tank. So everyone was really stoked to connect the cantons, and it kind of didn't happen. Turkish army moved in, FSA and the Syrian army moved in. So that's kind of on hold, and we're just going for Raqqa. What I was involved in was the first phase of the operation. Actually, my gun crew actually fired the first shots of the Raqqa operation. We took this town called Tel Simon. It was like kind of a major little farming town. And it was the first step into like an 8-part process where we're just going to encircle Raqqa and then just die there.
For anyone who's following you on Twitter, I mean, we saw you were in sort of like a homemade armored vehicle, just as sort of the, I guess, tip of the spear.
I went to like a heavy weapons tabor first. A tabor is like a platoon. I went to a heavy weapons board first, thinking that like it would just be easier because I'm lazy. But instead, we just went on operation like the second day after I got there, getting out of the training. I was in the homemade tank for a little bit and on a 20.3 anti-aircraft gun attached to the back of a truck. I think they call them technicals in the West, but we call them douchkas here. The tank was fucking wild, though, man. It's just concrete over a garbage truck.
Did it have an aux cord?
It did actually have an aux cord.
It's the human right.
And this like kind of fat, like there's like a few people I met here that are like clearly deeply autistic, which is too cool. I am obviously too. But this one guy, we'd sleep in there every night, and this like one real kind of porky kid would simultaneously put his every finger he had in his mouth, in my mouth, and turn on like Kurdish music full blast at 3 a.m. to help him sleep.
There's nothing.
Did that help? How did that? Did that help you sleep?
Yeah, man, I love sucking on a finger.
You know, so you said that you sort of stalled out in certain areas, but like overall, has the campaign against ISIS been successful from the YPG's view so far? Or is there still more work to be done before you can even consider something like that?
The thing is, there's like three lines of defense around Raqqa, kind of like three major actual fortifications they have. We kind of just chase them to those, especially in my part. They mostly ran when we came. They would leave like four people in each little village hiding in like snipers and stuff. They're kind of withdrawing to that and then just mining everything. There's mostly mines out here. That's the thing to watch out for. And mines fucking suck, man. Those things aren't cool at all.
Well, actually, I could give you a lot of advice, but on this specifically, I can give you some pretty good advice. If you press the you know, I don't know what system you're using, but if you press the crawl button, which I think is either X, square, or if you're on the Xbox, that's A, you can take the mine and put it in your inventory, but you have to crawl over it.
Well, that's why he's been doing all this crawling. And
yeah,
training.
Exactly. Yeah.
We actually have these like sabotage squads that are all. It's mostly women because their hands are smaller, but they do that. And it fucking sucks for them, man. It's a dangerous job.
Going back now, I mean, like this is where you are now, but I think a lot of people want to know how the fuck did you end up in Syria and why?
I tried to join Al-Nusra. but they weren't having me. There's something about Jews. I don't know. In 2012, I started reading about the PKK a lot, who again have no connection to us, and getting real kind of juiced on it. I mean, it seemed like one of the like kind of most effective armed struggle groups of the left. Actually, probably the most effective. So I kind of like looked at it more and more, and then I read this insane article about these like dipshits that came out here, like these kind of Christian guys that came out here to join the YPG and got freaked out because they're communists.
Oh right, they were sort of these like special ops American guys who were like thought of themselves as crusaders and just wanted to go back to like Iraq or whatever and take up the fight again.
Yeah, they call themselves the Sons of Liberty.
Yeah, yeah, and all like the Christians out here and shit. Like there's like Christian militias we have, but they're all like they all have like swastikas and shit all over them. They're insane. They're not Westerners. They're Syrians, but they love Hitler. Like dudes will just have like swastika tattoos, swastikas drawn onto their rifles and stuff. Anyway, so I read about these dipshits, and I figured that I am of course like I haven't played video games in a while, but I remember being pretty good at them. So I figured I could just do that out here. No, but I really wanted to like to join because it's. I don't know. I mean, maybe it's one part like me just trying, like feeling empathetic towards because it's a real fucked up here. And another part just like wanting to actually fight and see if I can. And they said, okay. They're trying to bring mostly left wing people out here now. There's like some apolitical people, but for the most part, everyone's pretty left. So I started emailing them and eventually they said, come out. So I came out. I flew to Sulaymaniyah in Iraq. Got taken to a safe house where this guy like sits me down at a table there and I'm real freaked out because I don't know who the fuck he is really, and I'm in Iraq and he's got like a pistol and shit. But he starts telling me that like if I want to do something that I have to like focus all my mental energy on it, because if I focus enough mental energy on it, that energy becomes actually material. And that I have to also make a dream board to get what I want.
That's
and
the
I realized
secret.
That he was just fucking explaining the secret to me. But yeah, he actually gave me a copy of the secret that I took with me here.
Oh my God.
just quickly threw away.
Positive thinking, Rashid. Positive thinking always. Okay, so like, yeah, so you get there, you go from a safe house in Iraq to where?
To the mountains, I'll just say.
Okay.
You can be
vague.
Sweet camp in the mountains. Yeah, I mean, I can't really be more specific because I don't really remember the name of it. But yeah, to the mountains in Iraq, and then some fellas and some helpful people. They they took us over. Oh, that's what they call me. They named me Rashid because everyone needs like a different, you know, code name. They took us to this river, and it's about like it's like 1 a.m. maybe 2, and we have to cross the border into Syria. Like we have to avoid the Peshmerga, the Iraqi Kurds, like kind of like armed force, because the border's closed. You can't go across. So we had to spend like maybe 8 hours crawling and then like blowing up an inflatable boat we got from the bushes and crossing this river. And there was like all these helicopters and stuff. It was very confusing because I figured out we only went like 5 kilometers, but it took us 8 hours. Yeah, and when we got there, these guys changed out of their pajamas and some different uniforms. And then I was in Syria.